Welcome back to another episode of the Ark Survival Guide. Today we are going to teach you all about dung beetles, and specifically show you where to find dung beetles in the Crystal Isles map that just came out for PC and should hopefully be coming out soon on console too. Now, dung beetles are one of the most underrated creatures in Ark because they are so useful. A dung beetle can actually convert all of your dino's poop into fertilizer and oil, and if you have a couple dung beetles, you can basically have an unlimited oil supply in your base. I thought this would be especially helpful because right now we have the Summer Bash 2020 event, which has a lot of jerky required to make all the cool items, and oil is actually required for jerky, so this is a really good solution for those of you who want lots of oil without ever leaving your base. And I'll show you a really easy taming method for dung beetles, which will make it really easy for you to grab a couple dung beetles and bring them home for producing all the oil you need for this event. Dung beetles are also amazing for producing fertilizer extremely quickly, which will make it so you can always have really good, easy-growing crops if you've got a garden. And if you use Plant Species X turrets to defend your base, a dung beetle will produce all the ammunition you need to keep your base safe from attacking dinos and players. And if you watch this video till the end, I'll show you some helpful techniques for keeping your dung beetles contained while they're wandering around producing fertilizer and oil for you. So be sure to watch this video until the end, it should be really helpful. And if it is, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends so it can help them out too. And make sure you subscribe to this channel and ring that bell for all notifications, because we have lots of helpful guides, tips, tricks, live streams, and let's plays coming your way, and you're not going to want to miss any of that. So, let's get started. So, we'll start our dung beetle guide showing you the spawn locations we can find dung beetles, and every green square and dot is a place you can commonly find dung beetles on the Crystal Isle map. Now, the southern coast here, all along the desert, are big green patches where dung beetles are actually pretty common to spawn, but there's a little problem. Usually, there's so many dangerous things in those areas, the dung beetles get eaten really quickly, because apparently they're delicious. I wouldn't want to eat that, but everything around there does, so by the time you get there, it's really unlikely any dung beetles will be left alive to tame. Now, if you look in the middle of the map, there's actually several little green dots, and those are actually where we'll find ant hills, and usually I find a couple live dung beetles around each ant hill, because apparently the ants actually like them for company. I wouldn't really want them as neighbors, but, you know, once again, to each his own. Now, in the top left corner of the map, we've got a couple spots in the redwood too, but I don't recommend going all the way up there, because the redwoods are crazy dangerous, and you're probably going to have other stuff interfering while you're feeding dung beetles poop to actually tame them. So I'm going to show you my favorite spots to get dung beetles and tame them next, and then we'll show you some places on the coast where you can get them if you're really lucky. Now, this is my favorite location to tame dung beetles, and part of that is because it's easy to access from a lot of places on the map. It's right about in the center of the Crystal Isles map, and you can see this waterfall is a good landmark, and we're right here on the edge of the swamp that's next to the jungle. So if you live in any of these areas, it's going to be a great place to go for dung beetles. Now, you got to be real careful on the coast, lots of dangerous stuff around the coast, but as you can see, there are all these big termite or ant mounds all around this area, and right next to those, you almost always find one or two dung beetles. So here's the location on the map where you can find these dung beetles, but there's actually several ant mounds around this little hill. Here's another one right here, and it's hard to spot, but there's another little dung beetle down there next to the ant hill in the shade. So here's the location of this one, and we'll actually find one more ant mound a little bit further up. Oh, there's this guy, now you can see him a little better. And up here on top of the hill, there's another spot with a couple more dung beetles next to that. So these are all great places to get yourself a dung beetle, and oh, there goes the ants. So do be prepared to be attacked by ants. Now, all the way up this river, there are several other ant mounds that will spawn, but there's also a lot of T-Rexes that spawn around here. So I recommend looking for dung beetles in those spots I just showed you, and we'll show you how to tame them very soon too. Now, this next location where you can find dung beetles is not my recommendation, but I'll show it to you anyway, just so you've got a chance, because it is close to the starting zones. So this coast is the closest area to the White Shoals, and it's right along the edge of the desert. That's actually the Dragon Lair right in front of me. And all along the coast are these little palm tree areas, and you can actually find dung beetles on any of these places along the coast, or just a little bit further up the beach. There's only one little problem, and that is they are covered and infested with all kinds of really dangerous stuff. So basically anywhere along this coast, you're going to get immediately attacked by praying mantis, which are really deadly, by the way, lots of scorpions, lots of arthropleuras, all kinds of stuff that will just tear you up. And the real problem with that is they will also tear up all the dung beetles as soon as they spawn in. So apparently all the other bugs around here love eating the bugs that eat poop. I'm not really a fan of that idea myself, but apparently that's their thing. So if you're really lucky, you might be able to sail a raft over here down the coast, and you might spot a dung beetle that hasn't been killed yet, but you do have to get very lucky, and you will have to stay far enough back from the coast that all the other nasty bugs won't kill you in the process. Now right here, we actually lucked out and found a dung beetle that happened to spawn far enough away from all these snakes to not get eaten the minute he appeared. So here's a spot right here where I happened to find one, and if you're really lucky, you might find one too, but once again, these snakes are going to come down and eat him any minute, so he's not going to last very long. You really have to just luck out and get the right timing. Also, these guys over here are actually jug bugs. They are not dung beetles, and they won't help you at all if you see something flying around, so it's another thing you've got some decoy bugs around here that may throw off your hunt. But if you're really lucky, this might be a great spot to snag a dung beetle, and you can sail here very easily on a raft from the White Shoals area, as long as you can avoid the lead scythes that like to lurk off the coast to eat your raft. Now, actually, taming a dung beetle is really easy, but getting a dung beetle out of the dangerous places they live is much harder. But I'm going to show you guys a really great trick that'll make it super easy to tame a dung beetle, even if they live in really dangerous places. So we're here on the edge of the swamp. There's a nice little plateau I could land and rest my pteranodon here. And if you've got a pteranodon, this will be a very easy thing to grab these guys. And I also brought a grappling hook with my crossbow, which is going to make this even easier. So I'm flying over to this ant mound, which is pretty close to me, but as you can see, there's a Carnotaur over there, there's actually a basilisk hidden on the coast, and there's lots of ants in the ant mound that want to eat me. Also over here are a couple raptors that are just waiting to pick a fight with me right on the edge there. Yep, you can see them there. So I'm getting the ants to chase me a little bit away from that ant mound, and as soon as they are clear, I'm going to actually land my pteranodon right next to the dung beetle, and I could technically just start feeding it feces. You put the feces in the last slot of your inventory and you run up and just hit E to tame them, but instead I'm actually going to shoot this guy with a crossbow, jump right back on my pteranodon and take off, and I only have to be on the ground for about 3 seconds before I can fly away with this guy. You can see that little pile, it looks like a pile of sticks on the coast, that's actually a basilisk waiting, and if you get too close it's just going to destroy you. So I can fly away with this dung beetle towing behind me with a grappling hook and land on a nice safe plateau over here where nothing dangerous is sitting right around here. I can see a T-Rex in the background. But I can run right up here. I have not disconnected the crossbow. I'll drop some medium dino feces into my last slot of my inventory and press E, and that's going to feed him. And now he's about 30% tamed already just with one medium dino feces. And while I'm waiting for him to be ready to tame again, I'm actually going to hop back on my pteranodon since he's still attached to my crossbow, and I'll fly all the way home and stop on a nice little safe plateau, feed him again when he's ready, and just keep hopping from plateau to plateau. And that way, by the time I get home, he'll be most of the way tamed up, and I'm not wasting any time. Otherwise, I would just have to sit there in the really dangerous area and hope nothing eats him while I'm getting him tamed up, and that's not really an ideal situation, so this trick makes it much easier. Another tip is, I actually prefer taming the lowest level dung beetle I can find, because that'll make it tame much faster, and it actually doesn't really help to have a higher level one. We're gonna level up some weight on its stats, but aside from that, it doesn't really make a difference. And once it has a high enough weight stat to carry four different feces, you really don't need that much more weight on it. Now also, the bigger the feces, the easier it is to tame, so one large dino feces would probably tame this level 25 dung beetle in probably 2 feedings, whereas small feces would probably take 10 to 15 feedings to get that tamed up. It will technically also eat spoiled meat, which is a little bit better than raw meat, which it also eats, but those take a lot of those to tame up, and you'll probably want to be safely at your base if you're going to tame it the slow way. It also helps that as soon as you tame a dung beetle, you can actually pick it up in your inventory and carry it, and you can hop on a dino saddle while you're doing that, which makes it much easier to get back to your base. And once we get this thing back home, I'm going to show you how to turn your dung beetle into an oil and fertilizer factory right in your home base. So now that we're back at the base with our tame dung beetle, we are going to start converting animal feces into fertilizer and oil. Now the first thing I'll do is make him stop following me so he doesn't chase me off a cliff, because they are prone to do that when you fly away. And we're going to drop some medium animal feces into his inventory. As you can see here, I can't put too much in there because his maximum weight is currently 5.8. Now weight is the only really important stat for a dung beetle, so we're going to add some weight to his stats so he can carry more feces, and that'll let him produce more oil and fertilizer. And now we're going to set him to wander, and we have to make sure he's actually able to move. He can't be completely overweight and stuck in order to actually produce oil and fertilizer. We also need to put some meat or spoiled meat into his inventory, because that's his actual food. He doesn't actually eat the poop, he just turns it into oil and fertilizer. And every 15 minutes he'll convert one of each type of feces into fertilizer and oil. So for example, if he's got 5 stacks of medium feces, he'll convert one of those every 15 minutes, but if he has 1 stack of small, medium, large, and human feces, he'll convert 4 of those every 15 minutes. So if you manage his inventory carefully, you can actually get way more fertilizer and oil. So we'll wrap up our dung beetle guide by showing you how to allow dung beetles to wander around while they're creating fertilizer and oil without actually having them wander off, because dung beetles are escape artists, and with a lot of dinos like an oviraptor that need to be on wander, their skill will still work if you just overload their inventory with too many rocks so they can't move around. But with dung beetles, they actually have to be capable of moving. But an interesting thing about dung beetles is if you carry them, you can carry them right through an open doorway like these, but they actually don't quite fit if they're wandering out themselves. So I can leave this guy on wander and he won't quite make it out of the door frames. He almost does, but they are escape artists and he'll eventually wander out after a long enough time. It just takes a while. So usually I recommend going ahead and adding the doors into the door frames, and that way you can make sure he won't escape while you're not looking. But you know, if you leave the doors open for a little while, it's pretty okay, and we can actually fit a couple of dung beetles inside this little 1x1 foundation, so it's not a bad enclosure if we want to keep both of our dung beetles in here. Now a lot of people will just use a technique like this, or just let them wander around in your main base. They won't really cause any trouble if they're just wandering around, but if you want to make sure your dung beetle stays put, a wooden cage is actually a really good idea. Some people don't want to waste the engrams on a wooden cage, but it'll definitely keep your dung beetles still, and it lets them wander and actually allows you to manage their inventory right through the front door if you're careful where you click on them. So that's another great option if you just have a couple cages full of dung beetles. And unless your dinos are producing tons of feces and you need lots of fertilizer and oil, you probably only need a couple dung beetles to process all of that. And another helpful tip if you need more animal feces is if you have an oviraptor on wander, it will give that egg laying buff to all the dinos in your base, but that also increases the amount that they poop, so that'll actually get you more feces for them to process. Well, hopefully you can now see why dung beetles are actually one of my favorite tames in Ark, and not just because I like collecting dinosaur poop all the time. I promise, I'm not weird. But dung beetles are extremely helpful. I used to have a couple dung beetles on my Raft Fortress on my Ragnarok series, and they would convert unicorn poop into ammunition for my Plant Species X turrets, and gasoline to power the electricity, so I had an entire organic battleship running on unicorn poop. But hey, even though this guide was technically full of crap, I hope you still really enjoyed it and found it really helpful. And if you did, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and make sure you subscribe to this channel and ring that bell to enable all notifications, because we have lots of helpful live streams, let's plays, guides, tips, and tricks coming out really soon, and you're not going to want to miss any of that. So until next time, stay safe, have fun, and we will see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching this video from the Ark Survival Guide. If you enjoyed it or found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up and share it on social media. That helps us so much. Be sure to subscribe to this channel and ring the bell to enable all notifications, because we have lots of awesome new Ark videos and live streams coming soon, and you won't want to miss any of them. You can do so many awesome things in Ark, but it is really hard to figure out on your own. Check out the links at the end of this video to browse our huge library of fun, clean, and helpful Ark guides, tips, tricks, live streams, and let's plays. If you would like to earn awesome rewards while supporting this channel, click the join button or link next to the subscribe button to learn more about our new channel memberships. You can also join our awesome Discord community at the link in the description of this video or on top of the channel homepage. And if you want to see my wife and I play lots of other fun video games together, visit our other YouTube channel, The Console Co-op Couple, using the link in the video description or in the channel homepage. And now I want to give a shout out to some of the biggest supporters of this channel: Sabo0283, Cole Parmenter, Wolfgirl Belike, Austin Nagel, Kelly Razjak, Black Silver Ride, and Emmy Fisher. You guys are all awesome, and we so appreciate your support. Now, if you'd like to be a monthly supporter and get a shout out at the end of our videos, check out the join button next to the subscribe button for more information about that. And for everyone else, thanks so much for watching, and we will see you in the next video.